March, a month unto which a portion of falls under the zodiacal sign of Aries. March would be the first month of the year. You can tell this because if you go to September, Septem would be Latin for seven, Octo, Latin for eight, Novem, Latin for nine, and Decem, Latin for 10, December being the 10th month of the year. A couple of weeks ago, I was talking with a fellow researcher here in Sydney, and I mentioned the equinox was coming up and to look out for bloodshed. Indeed, it has happened within Brussels, of course, and it has basically happened on the equinox. Now, in 2003, you had the invasion of Iraq, and that lasted the 40 days of sacrifice, as Mark Paustio terms it, right up to May Day. And of course, on May Day, you would have various protests and a bit of kind of bloodshed occasionally to do with that also, strangely enough. You also had the Operation Odyssey Dawn. Now, the dawn would perhaps be a reference to the sun there in this case in 2011 also. And further, there was quite a lot of bloodshed in Baghdad, Iraq in 2012 also. So we're now in 2016 and we have another event. You also have the Hunger Games there. Interestingly enough, I kind of noted that a couple of years ago, but so various things may get rolled out on the state. Now, whether people from the occult, the dark side of the occult, are behind this or not, I don't know. These events, but in the Hunger Games, I would certainly suspect so. That's kind of reasonably obvious to me. So on the equinox, the sun would rise in the east for everyone on the planet. And by the way, this would not happen on a flat earth model. So I'd just like to say that, you know, I'm blocking people, flat earth proponents, and flat earth proponents, please fuck off from my channel. I'm not interested in giving you information. I regard you all as scumbags and liars. So talking about scumbags and liars, yeah, there is the dark side of the occult and dark entities, and I would suggest that this has much more to do than the focus of Saturn, and I've sort of been sucked into that before also, but within the sun and the moon, the planets, and even within yourself, there's a dark aspect, but it's also, there's also the wider spirit world that just doesn't get a mention. At the end of this video, I'll play a bit by Sandra Fecht, where she actually talks about that. The notion of satanic rituals and all the rest of it, although I don't know that I'd use the word satanic, but the dark rituals and so forth. At the various seasons, the entities become available, if you will, through ritual to the mage, if you will. And this is talked about by an occultist, and I'll put a bit of a clip to that. And I've heard it in person from an occultist as well. He talks about the energies rising towards the end of the season. But the spirit world doesn't get a mention. It just doesn't. I guess it's off the radar for people. So the occult is so alive and well in 2016, where researchers, it's just not on the, people just don't talk about it, basically. It really is an occult thing.
But it's any kind of sexual abuse, torture, animal torture, teaching children to do harm to animals and other children. The satanic part of it, as it implies, involves Satan. And that is, those are usually more ancient ritual parts that really are able to conjure demons and other entities and bring them in. And shape-shifting, all of that sort of thing.
I learned in the Golden Dawn, and I'm used to the, you know, the elements being in this direction, but is that really what, you know, this old grimoire meant and everything? And I didn't want to jump to that, but it just turned out to be that way. The angels were very specified to their directions, and they were different than just elementals, but they are angels that correspond to these archetypical symbols of the elements they represent. I mean, the one in the west, the angel, notably a little bit more feminine, and it dealt a lot with, you know, what my emotions were doing and how to overcome some of the issues there. And the one in the south, and the red was all about, you know, my passion and well-being, able to put your energy into terms. So I could really recognize the kind of correspondence that they had with the elements, and I was thinking that might be, but I didn't really understand how much to each degree they were about that until I got through the second or third working. And I did this operation just about every single Sunday for over a year, and I worked with them during their time, and I only worked with the proper Omidel during their season and time, just like it suggests. And it was really interesting because I think I did a couple experiments where I wanted to talk to them one more time, ask them one more thing, but the time had changed out of their season, and it didn't work very well. And I was kind of surprised how strictly, I guess, either the maybe it was in me, but the angels seemed to kind of correspond to their time, and when you were able to call them up and hold the best conversations with them. I was only really successful during kind of the midst of their time, during their Quora time, and it was just a kind of a fascinating experience.